Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Some death road to Canada. A little bit of a research stream for what will likely be an after hour, assuming that I enjoy my time here. What kind of attracted me to this game is that you can create custom characters, which I thought might be amusing to stream. So, without further ado, let's get right on with it, shall we? Alright, here we go. Might want to knock our volume levels down ever so slightly. There we go. Alright, so, Death Road to Canada. A sort of 2D mix of kind of brawler, a bit of survival, and Oregon Trail, I think, is probably one of the best ways to describe it. The aim is to get to Canada, because apparently there are no zombies in Canada. But, of course, the road to get there is a little bit tricky. There's a lot of really weird stuff in it. It's by Rocket Cat Games, and I'm looking forward to seeing what nonsense happens. Now, the best thing about this is that you have a game mode called Familiar Characters. So what you can do is you can have most of your road recruits be familiar characters from the characters you've made. So I made 17 YouTubers, and we may very well meet a bunch of them along the way. They'll probably all die, I imagine. There's a couple of other modes as well. I'm not sure what they are, like rare characters mode, special characters with unique abilities. There's quite a few different modes, actually. Familiar Extreme. There's a very hard mode of Familiar. Kepa mode? I don't even want to know. Apparently very difficult. Alright, Familiar Characters mode it shall be then. Who shall lead us? I shall lead us! My perk is Friend of Dog. I befriend dogs easier. I am also fierce-tempered. And I am accompanied by Sheriff Jesse Cox, the infamous irritating martial artist. You know, I should have probably given him, I don't know, gunslinger. That might. He just seemed like he would enjoy the martial artist perk. Let me put it that way. Oregon Trail plus zombies is definitely a thing. It's called Oregon Trail. This is quite different to that. There's definitely a couple of similarities here and there, but it seems quite different. All right, here we go. Totalbiscuit hears rumors that Canada is a safe place, free of the threat of zombies. With nothing to gain from waiting around Florida, he decides to brave the death road and travel north. You can throw furniture, incidentally, in this game. The group finds a rundown factory, like most factories one would see nowadays. Sometimes people try to set up a safe hideout in a factory side closet, but this usually doesn't end well. Your zombie forecast is sparse. Aggression, irritated, and we are near noon. Alright, we'll explore the factory. Absolutely, we can totally do that. Absolutely do that. Alright, so I apparently start with a kitchen knife, and Jesse starts with nothing, because he is, of course, a famous martial artist. So, no, it's all good. Alright, in we go. So, as you can see, the zombie combat is a little bit odd. It's a sort of side-scrolling brawler. Get off. There we go. And we're going to be trying to raid this factory to see if we can find anything good. Thankfully, I have Jesse's martial arts skills to help me out, because this knife is terrible. Jesse can apparently punch zombies into pieces, which is a useful talent to have. So what we're looking for the most part, is like food, bullets, supplies, that kind of thing. You can find the occasional weapon as well. You know, a piece of wood does qualify as a weapon. Weapons, of course, needless to say, break. You also get tired as you continue to fight. So it's generally a good idea not to fight too much if you can avoid it. What is that? I don't know. Oh, it's food. Okay. Yeah, I believe you can pick up some furniture, just not all of it. All right, there's probably something in that fridge. So Jesse Cox, infamous martial artist, will fend off the zombies while I go and check it out. What's in the fridge? Food. Okay. We probably want to get out of here. I don't think there's anything else good in here. Wow, Jesse's just murdering everybody. I should have picked martial artist. Apparently that's the perk to go for. There we go. Need to find some more supplies. You need petrol for your car. And of course you need food. You need medical supplies if you're injured, otherwise you'll slowly die, which is never ideal. There's some food. And some more food. Whack that thing on the head. Those ones are generally quite unpleasant. Jesse, deal with him. Thank you. More like one-finger death punch to Canada. There we go. That's some bullets. We always like those. There you can meet traders along the road and stuff like that, so it's usually good to have that. Ah, there's a weapon. That's a golf club. That should do the job. I believe there's a room there we haven't looked at. Is there anything good in the toilets? The answer is no. I imagine this is a post-Trump world where all the weapons are golf clubs and destroyed bits of wind farm. Alright, I think that's everything in here. I don't think there was anything else. I don't think there's anything we missed. Maybe we could smash. I don't know if smashing the boxes up reveals anything other than pieces of wood. Oh, it looks like it does reveal some stuff. There's a metal pipe in there. As you can see, like, you get exhausted the more you swing, and it sort of depends on how fit you are as to how much you can do this. You slow down and all that kind of thing. Just, you know, these are obviously very difficult to break. But it's okay, you know, best way to break a piece of wood is apparently another piece of wood, so. There was a metal pipe around here. Oh yeah, I believe Jesse took it. Your NPC characters in your little mob can actually pick up weapons themselves and use them, which I thought was kind of neat. The music is hilarious. It's completely and totally unsuited to what's going on. Ooh, we're in sort of a power room here. It's okay, Jesse will kung fu chop through here. There's probably something nice in here. You can actually, like, change combat style. We're gonna go fighting. There we go. Jesse, you just go murder everything. That is really overpowered. He's just punching everything to death. You just deal with them. You'll be fine. I was hoping he doesn't get horribly mobbed. I don't think there is actually anything good in here. There's like a wrench. Well, that's about it. I can grab the wrench, but... Not the awesome loot that I was hoping for. I also don't think destroying these power transformers is a good idea, but... No, I don't think there's anything in there. That's a shame. Get out. I think it's time to leave. The zombies are starting to overcome us. Well, we got some food and some bullets. I would love to leave, thank you very much. We got six food and 15 bullets and killed 31 zombies. Killing the zombies. I don't know if that helps. I think it can level up certain attributes. That's about it. Yeah. I think that's about it. Cool. Now we have to get back to our car. Now, events happen while you're on the road, so you're going to make certain decisions. You can also get different kinds of cars, which are good. Grocery trust exercise. The group sets up camp outside a grocery store. They notice another group has been following them and will probably attempt to loot the place. Send one person in to loot? Who's going to loot it? Send in Jesse. Jesse can destroy everybody, apparently. Totalbiscuit stands guard outside as Jesse Cox searches the grocery store. Jesse Cox says there wasn't any food in there. My morale decreases. Jesse probably ate it all. Don't want to go to Canada. Suddenly, a giant fissure erupts across the road ahead. It's big, super big! And the asphalt buckles on either side, making for a pretty sick ramp. Gunnet! Obviously. Totalbiscuit grabs the wheel and pounds the gas pedal. The car bolts forward, ripping a howling screech into the sky. Jesse Cox is very happy about this. The car barely makes it, but sinks like an anvil and smashes into the ground. Chunks of the car fly in various directions. It took a beating, but it's still running. Good. Almost broke the car. Want to be a little bit careful about that. The group spots an infested city from the road. Scouting it from afar, the group has decided whether to fight under the noon sun for supplies. Well, I mean, there's not a large group of zombies. Grocery store is probably the way to go. We need some food. Let's go with that. Alright, I've got plenty of equipment. Jesse doesn't need equipment. Jesse just, like, murders people with his iron fist. Also, you can run over zombies in the car, which I thought is pretty great. Get out of it. Alright, let us check out this building right here. I'm not convinced about the efficacy of the golf club, but whatever. What is in here? Bullets! Lovely. Lovely casual zombie looting music in the background there. Some of the music you'd expect to find in the lounge of a nice but not too nice hotel. It's like reasonable, like a good 3.7 on TripAdvisor. It's like the restaurant and the hotel, it's edible. Like, the room service just seems overpriced for what it is, you know? It's like, this is okay. You wouldn't object to it per se. It's also the kind of place that calls a pizza a flatbread. I'm tempted just to swap this kitchen knife out for the baseball bat, because the knife seems to do almost no damage. Oh, nothing in there. Oh, there. I think that is about it for this place, the looks of it. We checked all the rooms, right? Yep, not much in there. That's fine. There might be a couple of other buildings around here. Oh, there's one that we haven't looted. Let's check that. Nope. Not a damn thing in there. There's supposed to be a grocery store around here somewhere, but I don't know where it is exactly. I do like the fact that it shows you which rooms you haven't been in by just putting a little glint on them. That's nice and convenient. Doesn't waste your time. I appreciate it when games do that. It's fine for a game where exploration isn't the massive focus. Not much in there. I mean, this is basically what you do in No Man's Sky, only you stare at a rock and hold the button down. Get- Where's Jesse? I think Jesse may have been murdered by the zombies. Jesse? I almost died there. Where is he? He's run off! The bastard- No, he's been in there looting things for some reason. Don't know why that is. Go on. I was almost murdered by zombies, you unreliable bastard. Nothing good in here. Oh dear, we're sort of stuck in there now, aren't we? I'm not sure why it's selected like the worst weapon that he has. Because I mean, he's a martial artist and his unarmed combat does huge damage and he's hitting people with a piece of wood. I'm not sure if you can stop them from doing that. Like, is that actually possible? It would be nice. It's like, do you really need this? No, you don't. I don't know. It seems like they just sort of make their own decisions as to what they want to use, which maybe is not optimal. Oh, I can also play as Jesse. So I could actually control him and... Can I get rid of this weapon? Is there a drop button at all? I mean, of course, I could just give it to him. There we go, and then I'd just use Kung Fu. There we go, because, I mean, that thing does an absurd amount of damage. I just don't see why you'd ever want to use a weapon on someone who has the martial arts perk when it one-shots zombies and doesn't break ever. Why would you? Nope, doesn't look like there's anything in there. Oh my god, I mean, you can go through an entire horde of them with it. Yeah, it is odd that a character with that perk would ever use a weapon. I don't really see the reason for that. I mean, of course, Jesse almost got eaten alive, but, you know, that's my fault. Not his. Alright, is that everything in this town? I haven't got a huge amount from it. The Kung Fu is a little hard to aim. But it does work very, very well. It doesn't seem to tire you out either. So it's actually worth using. That's where our car was. It's like there's some much more dangerous zombies over here. Ooh, there we go. There's the grocery store I was looking for. There's probably some good shit in here. Yep, food, food, food. That's what we like. I have no idea what that is. It's a spatula! My character decided to grab it. Can I hit them with the shopping cart? I'm going to assume I can. I'll pick up the trolley. There we go. Yes! The trolley is an extremely effective weapon. These larger zombies don't go down so easily with the Kung Fu. You can also, I think, pick up a corpse and throw it at people. Yes, you can do that. It actually breaks off to be a femur, which you can use as a weapon. That's amusing. Alright, I think that's everything in the store, by the looks of it. Oh, wait a second. Ooh, food on the shelves. Don't see anything else. Is that it? Well, we got a bunch of food out of it, so that was worth. I assume hanging around till nightfall is probably not a brilliant idea. Yes, it's starting to get a little nasty. Oh, I'm dead. Oops. Well, I mean, I was a necessary sacrifice, apparently. Time to maybe get back to the car and leave. Jesse's like, yep, okay. Goodbye. Get into the car. Start the car. Go. Well, that was unfortunate. Jesse is the only one alive. We'll have to find someone else. Jesse Cox camps for the night off a quiet stretch of the road and eats a decent meal. In the morning, there's a moose outside the camp. It looks injured and is just glaring at Jesse Cox. Even injured, a moose is a very powerful creature. Probably best not to mess with it. Jesse Cox wrestles the moose. I don't think we have a gun to shoot the moose with, but Jesse Cox could wrestle the moose. Jesse Cox wrestles the moose. Arms lock with hooves in a test of strength and willpower. He wins this pointless contest. It's a triumph over nature. The moose seethes over the loss and saunters away. Jesse Cox's strength increases. I probably should have, you know, just tried to kill the moose or something for food. Jesse Cox notices a foul smell going from the floorboards. Sulfur, rotting mutton, candy corn. A flash of white and the sound of a thousand whales exploding fills the car. The smoke clears to reveal the demon Hecatrice. He asks you if you have pizza. He could use a hot slice. Offer him a bag of chips. Thanks a bunch, dingus. The demon blasts Jesse Cox with spooky powers, then vanishes. His morale decreases, however, his strength and fitness increases due to the power of the demon. Jesse Cox is now demonic. Oh, he's also actually turned into a demon. Okay. Demon Jesse Cox is not doing too well. Outside of Canada, most of society and civilization has been destroyed. You can still find people engaging in trade, with preserved food being the new currency. You have 13 food left. That's not a lot of food. But... oh my god, he has a pitchfork as a weapon. Alright, so I assume he's selling ammo. He has a minigun. You can also try and rob people. He's holding a minigun with a scope, laser sight, and flashlight. I probably wouldn't fuck with him. So I could get a shotgun for 5 food. That seems reasonable. There we go. I don't have a lot of food, though. I could try and rob this guy. Jesse Cox meets a man who is carrying many swords. One day I'll make the finest zombie slicing sword ever seen. I just had to figure out how to make swords first. I'll sell you some that I found. Jesse Cox tells him to cool it is an option, or I can rob him. Cool it! The Blade Master ignores this. Starts talking about how swords are cool and never stops. Jesse Cox is forced to sneak out of the trading camp during his endless raving. Well, I got a shotgun, but I am lacking in food. There is only one of us, though. Whoa, it's Maggie! It's nice to see a familiar face. She's sitting around a park reading a book. Let's recruit Maggie to the team. There we go. Maggie looks like she's 65, but, you know, it's fine, I'm sure. Okay, we have a member of our team again. Maggie's attitude is terrible. Right. Onward to Canada we go. Demon Jesse and Maggie, the demon Cox. Oh dear. This city is covered with hordes of undead and wreckage that has been touched by a previous fire. The group gets surrounded and their only chance is sprinting through the sewers. Okay. Alright, let's see who can be equipped with what. Maggie has a frying pan. We have a shotgun. I'm not sure if I actually... I don't think I have any bullets for it. No. I think I have no ammunition for the shotgun whatsoever. But it's okay, because we have the devil fork and a metal pipe. And the power of Kung Fu. So it should be fine. Alright then. Here we go. We're supposed to just run through this, aren't we? I don't know, the devil fork is pretty strong. Oh, you can also hit people with the shotgun, it seems. You don't have to actually shoot it. Can't see anything. I was sort of hoping there would be some loot in here, but it doesn't look like it. I think it's just that you've got to run through the sewers. Nope. There's an area here. Alright. I don't know, this Devil Fork is like one-shotting most people, so I guess that's not too bad. Hello. Ooh. Oh, shotgun shells. Excellent. And an actual shotgun. I will... Yep, sure. I'll take that, absolutely. As I say, you can hit people with them, but you can also shoot them. I don't know, the Devil Fork seems to be a great weapon. I wonder if it'll actually break, though. Oh, God. How do I load this shotgun? That is a great question. Yeah, I have ammunition for it. I just seem to be swinging with it. More so than anything else. If I switch to Maggie and go either, Jesse will probably shoot. Tactic is currently running. So I can swap out the character that I control. There we go. That's a lot of people. Okay, we should change combat tactics so that Jesse actually does something. We fighting. There we go. Jesse, kill them with the demon fork. There we go. Get out of the way. You need 40 ammo to fire the shotgun. Really? Wow. Okay. Oh. We're all getting a little bit tired of the fighting. Can we get through here without dying? Oh god, there's so many. Just, no, no, just get it off me. Get it, just, no. Well, that's unfortunate. Everyone, apparently, who accompanies Jesse Cox on his death road to Canada dies. Well, Maggie's dead. That didn't take long. Time to leave. If I can find the way out of here. Get out. Too many zombies. This way. Hello, we found our way out. You didn't get a single piece of loot in that whole thing. Yes, let's get out of here, thank you. Well, we found some shotgun ammo and killed our friend. And we're also almost out of petrol. Jesse Cox feels inspired after managing to survive that situation. Really? Really? You had your friend killed. Morale and one health healed. Morale and random skill gain. One health healed is probably good. There we go. We really need some petrol, otherwise we're going to be in serious trouble. Jesse Cox finds an inn open for business. The owner wrings her hands. Give me 10 food, I'll watch over you while you sleep. Her. Okay. Say it, don't spray it. What on earth does that mean? Jesse Cox tells the woman to say it, not spray it. Her, you must be a big shot. I'll show you to the presidential suite. She kicks Jesse Cox out. He eats on the road, but never finds a secure place to sleep. Well, that's unfortunate. And this, we're about to run out of petrol. The car's completely run out of gas. We have to abandon the car. Okay, we need another car. Jesse Cox gets sandwiched by zombie hordes while on a cliffside road. Without a car, the only way to escape was by jumping and hoping for the best. The fall was painful and not fatal. Jesse Cox is hurt. This is not going well on the death road to Canada. While trekking through the woods, Jesse Cox gets pretty lost. If he keeps going like this, he'll waste a lot of time. Let's just climb a tree. Jesse Cox decides to climb a tree to get a better vantage point. His plan works out fine. He spots something in the distance and gets to see a majestic view. His fitness has been revealed as not very good. Okay. Well, we still have food at least. Oh, hello! Looks like we might be able to find a car here. Jesse Cox walks to a junkyard with a car pulled up in the front of it. The car looks like it will run, and it might be the last one you see for a while. Alright, explore the junkyard. Absolutely. Hopefully we can find what we need here to survive. It's okay, I have the demon fork, which apparently just kills everything and hopefully never breaks. Excellent, some petrol. Lovely. Yeah, this is a great place. There's barely any zombies. And there's a ton of loot. I'll take that. more petrol. Lovely, lovely. That's our problem solved. You can get out of the way. What's in the fridge? Food. We love it. Excellent. The adventures of Demon Sheriff Cox continue. Everyone that gets near him dies. It is a curse. But his survival is guaranteed as long as he sacrifices the innocent blood of others. Food and shotgun shells. That van, that's good. We'll take that van in a bit. I just wanna, since there's so few zombies here, I wanna explore this junkyard and get maximum loot. The fork is still not broken. I'm not sure if it's even possible to break it. Medical supplies? Lovely. Bullets? Yes, absolutely. No complaints about anything in here yet. More food. There's a set of keys there. I wonder if they're for the car. There's a set of keys, including the car keys. Yes, okay, so I guess the point of this area was to explore to find the car keys. So you can get out of here. That's fine. Some more bullets. Good, good, good. Ah, this is a trove of loveliness is what this is. I think that's it, loot-wise. Yeah, I think we've got everything. I'm gonna check over here to the right, but I think that's about it. These zombies are absolutely terrible, so... Cool! Alright, let's take the car, shall we? Get out of here. Wonderful! Well, we've stocked up. Let's see if we can find somebody else to kill on the way. Whoa, it's Cry! It's nice to see a familiar face. Not that we really know. It could actually be Cry or not. We just wouldn't know that, would we? He was being thrown out by his former group. They seem pretty angry. His trait is calm under fire, and his perk is he is mega buff. Of course he is. Jesse Cox accepts Cry to the team. Onward to Canada. The van takes a lot more petrol. Group sees a hospital. Medical supplies can often still be found in places like this due to the large amount of undead still wandering around. Yeah. Sounds like a good idea. What's Cry's gear? He has a metal pipe. I guess we give him... actually, his shooting is terrible. I mean, give him the shotgun. I'm not going to use it. I'm just going to use that demon fork. I don't see any reason to use any other weapon at this point. Pretty sure it doesn't break, and it's very, very good at what it does. Alright. Jesse Cox will be team leader. He is very unfit, apparently. That's a lot of stuff, but it's okay. We have a shot. Oh, God. Okay. I was gonna say, we had a shotgun. I think he's just burned through all the ammo for it, but let's go this way. There's too many zombies. Too many zombies. I mean, we're not doing too badly, really. As long as we don't run out of shotgun ammo. Stop shooting the wall. Bloody hell. As long as we don't run out of shotgun ammo, I think we're going to be fine. More medical supplies. Good, good. Get at. Look at this. It's a pile of dead bodies. Very effective. The demon fork will save us. But at what cost? That is a cane. Okay, I don't think we need that. Just poke him! Jesse's getting a bit exhausted. We need to increase Jesse's fitness. His fighting prowess is being impeded. Canes everywhere. We need some medical supplies, not this. Cry's just macking the hell out of these fools. Right, so we got one out of here. Get out of here now. Is that it? Looks like that might be it for the hospital. Oh, bloody hell! I forgot there's a bunch over there. They actually do come through the door as well, to the other room. Come on, get in here and use that shotgun to finish the rest of them off. That is a good weapon. We're gonna run out of ammo for it shortly, probably, but... It seems like it's worth looking for ammo for the shotgun, because you kill large groups with it very effectively. Nothing in here, I don't think. That looks like food, or medical supplies. I just don't get the weird, casual, happy soundtrack to this game. It's such a strange, strange decision. Get out of it. My fork is still not broken. I don't think it is possible. Always nice to have an infinite weapon. Oh, that almost killed Jesse. He almost got hit. Almost got eaten there. I think we might have to get out of here before Jesse gets eaten. He's my best character. I think that's it. Oh, we haven't been through this door. I saw a glint over there. It looks like there is something useful in the toilet. A bullet. Great. Okay, time to leave, I think. We've gotten all that can be gotten. Can't remember where the exit is for this place. This way, I think. Oh, no, we haven't been through it yet. Nothing in there, nothing in there. Oh, looks like there's food or medical supplies over there, though. The problem is, Jesse's one hit from death, so I want to make sure he doesn't actually go down. Oh, loads of medical supplies. Good. I think once I get back in the car, I can fix Jesse's health up. I don't know if any of us actually have any medical skill. I guess we'll find out. I mean, it's relative. The exploration is relatively simple, but, you know, it's still fairly enjoyable. And the rest of it is, for the most part, resource management and sort of Oregon Trail-style stuff. Which is fine. There was petrol in the toilet. That does not seem particularly sanitary, but I'm getting the hell out of here. What I'm trying to figure out is what that... There's a maple leaf up there, and is that the number of days to get to Canada? I guess that's what it is. Yes, let's get the hell out of here. Cool, 11 medical supplies. And killed 89 zombies, very nice. And Jesse absolutely needs... There we go, Jesse's got some health back now. Cry's medical is terrible, but it was able to help a little. The mystery of the ghost fart. It's just another day on the death road when someone farts in the car. Drama and mystery consume the team! Pick someone to blame. Jesse Cox, Cry, or Jesse Cox can tell Cry to cool it. Jesse Cox should tell Cry to cool it. Jesse Cox tells Cry to cool it. Beads of nervous sweat roll down Jesse Cox's face, yet nothing can be proven. His morale has decreased. And Cry's morale has also decreased. They're all gonna kill each other. Jesse Cox has been fully healed, that's always good. The group camps out in a pro shop near a golf course. Jesse Cox looks out the window and sees a large group of zombies approaching from the driving range. Hmm. I don't know if we want to hang around here. Drive away with no sleep, I think. The group decides to flee the golf course. They end up not finding another good place to sleep and drive for most of the night. They are very tired the next day. Well, I'm sure that'll be fine. It's probably not fine. The group drives through a ruined suburb. There's a few buildings that look like they haven't been completely trashed. Alright. Sluggish zombies, that's fine. We can handle that, right? We have a bunch of golf clubs that we got from there. Shotgun has no ammunition in it anymore. We'll have to find some. Alright. Let's try and find a house that hasn't been completely looted. Nothing in there. I think the best thing about this game is probably the random ass events. Like, it's the same sort of thing that I liked in Reigns, bunch of unexpected nonsense. But there seems to be like team management and not trying to piss off the rest of your team. I imagine if I piss off Cry enough, he'll probably try and kill me or something, which might be quite amusing. And obviously putting all your friends into the custom character mode and playing it that way. It's always entertaining. But XCOM becomes 10% more entertaining when you name all of your people your friends and then have them all horribly killed by aliens. This is a similar principle. Good loot, good loot. This is all keyboard control. There's no mouse aiming at all. You can use the mouse for the menus, but outside of that, it's all keyboard controlled. So it's just 8-directional digital, which is, it's easy to control, really. It's not even a problem. I mean, it's not like there's a huge amount of precision required in it. It really is just slowly move around and kill the zombies before they reach you. You get like a couple of seconds if a zombie reaches you, and otherwise they'll bite you and you take health damage. I think you can only take about 3 or 4 hits before you die. Alright, that house was lucrative. Don't really want to push through there. Oh, that's actually an exit. Never mind then. Get out. It seems like killing zombies probably does not improve your skill in any real way, so there's... outside of getting them out of the way, there's really no purpose to it. There's a house we apparently haven't been in. The film grain's a bit annoying. I'd probably turn that off. I assume that's in the options menu somewhere. Except I don't know how to get to the options menu. Evidently, it does not escape, because that is an issue you want to quit. Oh, some shotgun shells. We love that. Cry will probably burn through those in a matter of seconds. And another shotgun. What are you doing? I think I'll grab that shotty. I'm not gonna ask. In here by the looks of it. But yeah, if you don't have a lot of tolerance for exploration and looting, then you're probably going to get pretty pissed off at this game quite quickly. Because there is a lot of that. There's not like a huge amount of variance in the like types of zombies I've seen so far, enemies-wise, and it seems like it's only zombies. Like, I haven't encountered like looters or bandits or anything. I assume they're in the game, I just haven't run into them yet. I know there are events involving bandits. I'm not sure if you actually ever have to fight them directly, or if it's just an event. I think that's pretty much everything this house has to offer. I'm still running relatively low on petrol. I think we needed some more of that, but I'm not sure where I'll find that. Well, the character creation, I kind of already shown. It's just you pick a perk and, like, a characteristic, and then you just have a few different options as to how they look. That's pretty much it. It's nothing too fancy. I think that's probably all this town has to offer, from what I can tell. Let's get out of here. Can we stop hitting the car every time? There we go. I like how you run over the zombies on the way out. Well, we got some food and some pistol ammo. But petrol's gonna be a problem. And we have to abandon the car again. Well, shit. Group runs into a particularly rough stretch of road. There's nothing life-threatening about it, it's just long and miserable. They get bruised and battered in multiple small accidents. Cry's morale is decreasing heavily. The group is ambushed while crossing a rickety bridge. The bandits demand a toll to cross. They want 9 food. I think we should fucking murder them. Or we could threaten to burn the bridge. Fight them. The group knows that every single one of their supplies are essential for their chances of reaching Canada, so they fight. And we all got hurt as a result. So I guess you don't get to fight them directly. The group finds a rest stop after hours. It looks like there's a car and the keys must be nearby, but there is a moderate swarm of zombies here, which is in itself a bit of a problem. We have a few shotgun shells, which might be enough to help through. Alright, well, we'll give it a try. There's some petrol, that's good. Is that the car? Alright, that is what we're gonna be in. Alright. Well, gotta go find the keys before we get horribly murdered. The keys may be in here. If not, we could use some loot anyway. Food, good, good, good. Should probably just burn the bridge, I guess, or threaten them. Yeah, I think if you find this sequence to be dull, then that's going to kill your enjoyment of the game, because that's where you're going to spend a good amount of time. Otherwise, the most entertaining part of the game isn't this. The most entertaining part of the game is very clearly the interactions between the characters and the random events that can happen, as well as the resource management element. This is kind of filler. I mean, there's nothing necessarily bad about it. Oh dear. Don't get surrounded! That's it. Oh shit! Jesse's beat. I think we all just got eaten by zombies. Yep. The entire team was eaten by zombies. We died. This bit it's fine. You know, it's a decent filler. I assume once you've got kind of a nice sized team with varied weapons, it's probably a lot quicker to go through. But, you know, just like Oregon Trail, the fun part is making the decisions and seeing whether or not it gets you killed. Well, everybody's dead. I guess I can show you the character creation now. There's not a lot of it. This is a very good impression of Northern Lion, as you can see right here. Basically, you get to pick perks. These are leveled up somehow. Train shooting 19 more times. Train medical 20 more times. So I guess this is like stuff that you do in games. So you can get the perks up to 3-star. And there's also traits, which usually have upsides and downsides. And then you can change faces, change hairstyles, hats, of which there are various. Put a beard on them or whatever. Skin color, hair color, gender is under body. And then you've got a couple of different clothes and stuff like that. I don't know what that is. Yeah, everybody is dead. We can try again. We'll give it another shot. I am friend of dog. I need to find a dog. Apparently you can recruit dogs. Alright, let us see if we can perhaps survive this time. The group spots a house on the road. It looks fairly quiet from the outside, but looking through the window reveals shapes lurching around in the dark. That's fine. We can go loot that. I have a piece of wood. And Jesse Cox is, of course, a kung fu master, so I think as long as we set Jesse Cox to fight everything, we should be fine. Because he apparently just murders everything without any problem at all, so that's fine. Good, good. I'll say I think the replayability of this is going to come down to how many events there are. There are a number of different modes, I did see that. So there's a lot of unlockable modes, which will give it a little bit of replayability. But obviously, in a game like this, you sort of, entertainment-wise, you're kind of limited to how long you can go before seeing all of the wacky and weird events. Because once you've seen them all, then the game sort of ceases to be as entertaining. So, that could be a potential issue. I mean, I'm having fun with it so far. I'd say these looting sequences maybe could be a little bit more interesting. I think the combat could maybe be fleshed out. It might be just be that I haven't found all right weapons yet. I mean, before the stream, I found a blowtorch. Apparently, you can also get a flamethrower, and there's a bunch of like really good weapons you can get. That probably makes the combat a hell of a lot more fun than just swinging away with your fist or a piece of wood. I mean, you can throw furniture around, which is quite entertaining, but not all of the furniture can be thrown. So that giant chair, I can't pick that up. But I could loot the bin, then take the bin, and then throw the bin at a zombie. That is something that you can do. The music is also highly entertaining and silly. Very Super Nintendo. Oh, we've been in here, aren't we? Get out. Not much of a fighter, more of a lover. More of a diplomat. Scholar. Alright, we have some food, that's good. We have some medical supplies and a small amount of ammunition. That wasn't too bad. The group finds an abandoned campground with a fire pit. Jesse Cox even finds an old, somewhat stale, large pack of marshmallows. We should eat them. That gets us +2 food. Very good. The group finds an abandoned safe house. There's a little bit of ammunition inside. On further searching, some unfinished pipe bombs are in the building. Someone must have had to leave them in a hurry. Messing with them could be really dangerous. Sounds great. Let's finish them. Ow. Turns out, not very good at mechanical stuff. I attempt to finish making the bombs, and I'm not comfortable enough with work like this and makes a mistake. Everyone is hurt, and my mechanical skill has been revealed as awful. Well, that's going to use all of our medical supplies. I don't think we even have enough. The group drives through a city that hasn't been completely overrun. We should look for supplies. Let's go to the arcade. And I'm almost dead already, which is great. We don't even have any weapons. I expect our chances of survival to be slim. Very, very... Yep. I mean, I did expect that. It's okay. Jesse Cox will survive once again. I probably should not have attempted to finish the pipe bombs. The arcade machine seems to be working. It's not very clear how it can run without electricity. With no one trustworthy nearby to watch out for zombies, playing it could be dangerous. Play it. Jesse Cox plays an old arcade game named Ultra Death and really gets into it. Like all video games ever made, playing it increases your skill with guns. The critics were right. Before Jesse Cox knew it, 2 hours had passed. There was no one around to defend Jesse Cox during the process, so he had to fend off zombies while playing. Okay then. Well, that is an event. That sure is a thing. I can't wait for the kill screen article about how that's problematic. Let's get out of here. And I'm still being eaten, which is not ideal. Can I save his body from being... I can throw him at others! you can use them as bait! That is amusing. Yeah, you throw the body and that'll actually cause the zombies to go after it. And you can use the bodies of your fallen friends as bait. it's how he'd have wanted to go. Alright, we need to get some supplies and get the hell out of here. Looks like a zombie Hitler. There's a little house here. That's probably got a few things in it. Junk. Martial arts is a very good perk, I have to admit. I don't know if teammates will resurrect the zombies. I've never seen that happen. It may. That would be quite amusing. Food, food, food. Good, good, good. Nothing in there that's worth having. It's okay, the relaxing lounge music will make sure that everything remains just fine. Alright, nothing in there. Ooh, hello, what is this? It's a broom! I can't imagine that being massively useful, but hey. It's got some range on it. The amount of damage it does is minimal, but it seems to knock over zombies, so we can grab all the food that's in here. Get out of it! Get out of it! Uh-oh. I think it might be time to leave. I should stick to the martial arts skills. They seem to work far better. Lounge is tomorrow. Lounge is on Sunday. Not today. Lounge is never on Saturdays. Alright, time to leave, I think. I think we've pretty much got everything that can be got. Well, we need to find another companion for our journey to Canada. Not sure who would trust going with Jesse. Everyone with Jesse dies, apparently. We don't have enough medical supplies either. Which is not brilliant. So if I take one more hit, I'm dead. Jesse Cox is ambushed by a yelling man. He's ranting and raving. He doesn't look particularly dangerous, but those rants are starting to sizzle. Fight him. Jesse Cox is killed. That was a terrible idea. Well, one more attempt on the death row to Canada. I think this time we need a different leader, someone more reliable. No? Okay, never mind. Okay, let's quit that. Okay, never mind. We'll do that again. That's fine. The group spots an abandoned Yule Mart off in the distance. It looks like it's been looted, but maybe there's some untouched loot in there. Alright. Son of a bitch. Oh, I started with an umbrella. Very useful, yes. I always seem to start with an awful weapon. I assume there's a reason for that. Anything around here we can get? There we go. There's gotta be loads of food in here, right? Oh, this weapon sucks. Basically, there's almost no damage. The trolleys are much more effective weapons than the umbrella. Tons of ammo in here. It is a Yule Mart, after all. I guess that's to be expected. Hello. What we got here? Ooh, lots of food. And some petrol as well. Nice. More food, more food, more petrol. Yes, yes, yes. Is there anything in any of these boxes? I don't think you can actually break these. Alright, I think that's about it. Oh, hello, there's a pistol here. That'll be useful. Yeah, so there are firearms in this game. And that's kind of how they work. You sort of... It depends on your skill, I believe. And you stop moving and then it gives you a chance to hit. And they're pretty effective. Especially if you have good firearm skill. Alright, I think that's about it. Oh, hello, there's another door here. I'm gonna investigate that. And ammo is relatively plentiful. It's just there's no real benefit to actually shooting the zombies. You don't get anything from it. But it's less risky than getting meleeed. Alright, piece of petrol in the toilet, of course there was. Let's get out of here. Frankly, I'm more confident with the trolley. Alright. Time to leave. Alright. Excellent, excellent. The group camps in a sturdy building. It seems to be an old repair shop with busted machinery laying around. This would be a great time to train with repairing things, but it would make a lot of noise. I'm cool with that, let's tinker. Who should tinker? I will tinker. I spend all night taking things apart. My mechanical skill has increased. But the group will be very tired tomorrow. I mean, that makes sense. God damn it, Jesse, shooting down my brilliant ideas. Let me dream. Tread softly. Oh dear. Alright. Let's see how this goes then. The group drives through a city that hasn't been completely overrun. We should look for supplies. Bookstore, grocery store. We have plenty of food, I think. So let's go to the bookstore, see if we can find something useful, maybe. That would be nice. I don't know if you can ever have more than two characters with you. I assume you can have, I think you have three. I've never had three. Lots of bullets. Lots of a whole lot of nothing. I do wish there was a sprint button. I'm not sure if there is. Maybe I'm just doing it wrong. Don't care about it. You get to the point where you just start ignoring the zombies because they're just in the way for the most part. Well, that was all that was in there with the exception of this door. Nothing. Okay. The umbrella's good for knocking zombies over. It doesn't really kill them though. It's good for getting them out of the way. Alright, where's that bookstore? That was around here somewhere, wasn't there? Evidently not that way. Unless that was the bookstore that we just went in. Oh no, there it is. So you usually get whatever the location is that you picked, and then a couple of random houses which may or may not have stuff in them. Bullets, bullets, bullets. Good, good, good. A them there. I like the fact that you can tell instantly whether or not there's anything in a room because of the sparkles. You just have to wait a couple of seconds for them to pop up. And I was like, right, this is a waste of time. I don't need to worry about pressing Z or E on anything, which is nice. I appreciate it when games do that and don't waste your fucking time. Uh-oh. Well. It's okay, I have this chair, which is evidently way better than anything else. And Jesse will defend me with his kung fu arts, so it's all good. Do we really only have one food, or is that what I collected? Are we actually that low on food? I thought we had way more than that. Maybe that's just what I collected this run. Nothing in there. And some bullets. Yeah, I guess that is all we have left. Well, hopefully there's some food in the bookstore. Yes. Wait. We can't even get in there. No, we're not going to abandon the car. Alright, so apparently you can't even go into the bookstore. That's a bit weird, considering the bookstore was supposed to be our destination. Alright. Well, I guess we'll get out of here then. I don't think there's really anything else to look at. There might be another building we haven't looked in. Nope, doesn't look like it. Everything else we've already visited. Ah, yes, okay. So it is just your run. Okay, good. I thought we had no food. It's like, really? I thought we had way more than that. Food's really important because it's the currency that you use at the traders. We have loads of petrol, so that's good. What? Jesse Cox meets another survivor who rants about seeing an oiled-up bodybuilder that was too swole to control, ripping zombies in half. Totalbiscuit cruelly calls the woman a muscle nerd. What the fuck? I am awful! The group camps out in a big field and eats a decent meal. We find a row of cans shut on a wooden fence. Shoot the cans! The group gets some shooting practice in. A man with a red long johns runs onto the field with a pitchfork. My cans! My precious antique cans! Oh, that's a Simpsons reference, isn't it? He shakes the pitchfork as he yells, and I do not care. Jesse does not care. Jesse's loyalty has been revealed. Ha ha! There we go. Cool, so we did get some shooting skill out of that. The group gets frustrated because the CD player in the car is jammed, playing the same song over and over again. Who should try and repair it? I think we're both terrible at mechanics, aren't we? Jesse Cox tells Totalbiscuit to cool it. This, of course, doesn't help in the situation at all. The CD player remains broken and annoying, and everyone's sad about it. We are running low on food. Oh, a trading camp when we have 7 food left. That's not brilliant, but okay. We can go try and rob them, I suppose. That might work. Who's selling what? Is that Northern Lion? No, he just said... No, he has hair. The rifle-wielding woman claims she's used to train others in competitive shooting. Say it, don't spray it. I don't think that helps. And we have to be forced to leave because Jesse has insulted everybody. Well, that's unfortunate. Why don't you just try to rob one of them? Whoa, it's Crendor! It's nice to see a familiar face. He's humming a little song and hasn't noticed the group yet. Recruit Crendor to the team. His trait is he has a mysterious past, and of course he's a very athletic type. Group accepts Crendor to the team. Onward to Canada. Cool, we have a group of 3 now. Oh god, it's a siege. Well, we're fucked. The group is about to explore a small house when they notice a horde is creeping nearby. The group will have to hold their ground for a bit before they can escape. So it's a game length of 1 hour, and we have to just... It's basically survival. Well, fuck me. Alright. Weapons-wise, we have a piece of wood, a hockey stick, and this gun, and that is it. Brilliant! Crendor's gonna die. Just immediately. Oh god. All right. At least I have a gun. And it's shit, apparently. To the corner! I'm rapidly gonna run out of all bullets at this point. Oh, there's a piece of wood there, well, cool. I should probably take that, because it is a weapon. How long have we been in here? It's 11:30. It's an hour-long siege. Alright, I have this chair. We're good. There you go. More furniture. 11:40. Go! More furniture! Crendor with a hockey stick. Oh, wait. There's some of the loot here. Ooh! Shotgun ammo for the shotguns that we don't have. Let's go to the other room. Oh, we're stuck. Damn it. A siege is over. We can try and escape. Okay. That would be great. This way. This way! I've run out of chairs. There was a room through here, but it's actually blocked off. Alright, let's try and leave then, shall we? Yes, I would love to leave this location. It is entirely pointless to be here. But we have three people alive, which unfortunately means we're gonna end up losing a lot of food. The group feels inspired. Choose a reward for the group. Morale and random skill gain, I guess. Let's go with that. Every day is a great teacher as long as you don't get eaten. My fitness increases. Crendor's medical skill increases. Crendor's morale increases. And Jesse Cox's fitness increases. Now we need food. Everyone is happy. Jesse and Crendor are getting along swimmingly. That was all our food, so... Alright, I'm thinking we just shoot the moose at this point. Wrestling the moose does not help. I think we just shoot it. Crendor missed. Crendor tries to shoot the moose. This isn't very sportsmanlike. He whiffs the shot. The moose isn't happy about it and stomps him up real bad. Crendor is horribly hurt and it's a terrible shot. Well, we're out of food and Crendor is bleeding badly. And we don't have the medical supplies to treat him. So, and now we have the mystery of the ghost fart. Who is responsible for it? I say Crendor is responsible for it. Crendor is blamed. He shrugs in a good-natured way and his attitude increases. But our morale has decreased. Was this a real culprit? Who can say? We need food. Very badly. Whoa, it's Peanut Butter Gamer! It's nice to see a familiar face. She, wait, what? Is being thrown out by the former group. Alright. Peanut Butter Gamer is part of our team. We have four people, but we have no food. So it might be a good time to maybe, I don't know, find some. It's a siege with a very large horde. We are fucked. So we can attempt to rescue someone or we can just leave. Because I'm thinking just, I don't know, fucking leave at this point. I don't want to do a large horde right now. Okay, apparently we have to do another one. This is even worse. Keep driving. No. Don't help them. All right, now this will be fine. There we go. Jesse Cox knew some people that became crazy preppers long before the zombies happened. Their cabin is located nearby. It's still fairly early in the day. Right, okay. We have a veritable army. And Peanut Butter Gamer has an axe. We're looking good. Crendor's about to die, but this shouldn't be too bad. Alright, here we go. We have a veritable army of people now. We'll be totally fine. Let's go find this cabin, which is hopefully full of great loot. Oh, Jesus. There's a lot of people in there. Shotgun shells. Nice, nice. Bullets. Can I shoot these guys without shooting Crendor? Well, Crendor just broke all of his guns. All of his weapons, even. There's baseball bats over here. Come get him. Come get him. There we go. Everyone has baseball bats now. Excellent. I could use some of that. Oh, there's so much stuff in here. Food, 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 food. Excellent. Yes, yes. More guns. I have so much ammo. This is wonderful. Can grab that pistol. Or that. Yeah, I'm just going to stick to guns, I think. Seems like the way to go. All right, nothing else in here. A little army is doing fairly well right now. I don't think we can fit anyone else in the car. I think you need a larger car if you want more people, or maybe four is the limit. I'm not sure. Anything else in here? There's also a little glint over there. Nope. All right. Well, I think that was their cabin. I don't think there's anything else out here, but we got quite a lot from that. So I'm not exactly upset by how that went down. I need to get back to the car now without getting Krendor killed. We did get a decent amount of medical supplies, I think. So that's good. Alright, time to leave. The car's not starting! Go! 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 There we go. We didn't get much medical supply out of that. I thought we had way more than that. But we did get a bunch of food. Also, the car appears to be breaking down. This car should have no problems getting to Canada. I don't believe you in the slightest. God damn it. Oh, that was most of the food we just got. We need medical supplies really badly. A junkyard with a car. Alright, cool. We could swap out the car, because this one I think is about to explode, so... yeah, let's go with that. There's no point in me having two guns, is there? They both use the same ammo pool, I think. So, what was he got? He has a rusty machete and a baseball bat. Alright. I'm gonna junk these items, because Jesse's just better doing the whole kung fu thing. And... actually, Jesse's firearm skill's better as well, isn't it? So, let's say we give him one of those pistols. Oh, it looks like you need to get, like, a stack of 90 ammo to make that work. Alright, well, hopefully we'll get some ammo in the process. Alright. This should be fine. There's not a lot of any... ooh, that looks great. I want that car. I'm not sure if we can all fit in that, but... give it a shot. More importantly, though, we need medical supplies and food. There's some food. Good. Oh, bloody hell. Thankfully, Jesse's kung fu skills get us out of trouble once again. And there should be a lot of petrol around here as well. I'm going to swap out the car for the other one, which is hopefully better. There we go. Still looking for those medical supplies, though. Anything good in there? No, there should also be car keys around the place somewhere. Get off. I have enough minions to help me, so that shouldn't be a problem. There's the car keys. Yoink. The question is there anything else good around here? Uh-oh. I'm starting to run a little low on ammunition. Anything? Oh, yeah, there's a bunch of dumpsters over here. We can grab some stuff from there. Oh, good, good. Medical supplies, nice. Let's have my horde of melee guys just work through here. Did we see any more dumpsters along the way? Oh, that's the machete gone. Ooh, there's one. I think that's about it. Unless there's another building over here. I didn't see one in passing. I think we have everything that this place has to offer. Alright, let's nick this car and hope this car is better, because that one is fucked now. Mostly broken. Alright. We have a much better car now, I assume. Food, some petrol, not too much. And Krendor got his wounds treated, which is nice. Alright. And that's, again, the trader camp. when we have almost no food to trade. I'm thinking we rob people, if possible. The group runs into someone selling extra ammunition. No, don't need that. I need medical supplies. Is there anyone here selling those? Hey, get out. No. I want your shotgun shells. One grenade for four food. I don't think a grenade is a good idea. I don't see that going well for us. Like, these weapons, maybe. Let's rob the trader. The Blade Master managed to fight off the group using his considerable sword knowledge. Everyone is hurt, and we're forced to flee. Well, that's unfortunate. And everyone's almost dead. And we're running out of petrol again! And our new car, we are now out of... While trekking through the woods, the group gets pretty lost. Krendor climbs a tree. His plan works out fine, he gets a majestic view, increasing his fitness and morale. While walking, Krendor stubs his toe badly. He's gonna die from a stubbed toe or something, isn't it? Well, there are some cars here, but there's a lot of zombies. We got a couple of machetes, I don't know where we got those from, but that's fine. The inventory management actually is not that bad, it's just you can use... You can actually use the mouse and it makes that much, much easier, so... I'll take the femur just in case. Alright, can we make it through here without fucking up and getting everybody killed, is the question. We have a couple of machetes which should help. Petrol, good. Lots of petrol. There's a lot of zombies here. I think Jesse's kung fu skills plus our machetes should do the job. Pretty much out of bullets. Okay, so that is our car, I assume, but we don't have enough keys for it. No, actually, this doesn't need keys at all. We're getting out of here. The road ahead has been flooded out, but it looks like the car could maybe still get through it. Do we take a detour or plow through? Plow through. The group decides to take a chance to plow through, but it does take some damage. Okay, I'll be alright. There's also a very high-speed car, so it should get us to Canada quicker. The group sets up camp outside a grocery store. They notice another group has been following them and will probably attempt to loot the place. Send one person in to loot it. Jesse can loot it. There wasn't any food in there. I don't believe him for a second. Everyone's morale decreases. Should have sent in someone trustworthy. And we're out of food. And medical supplies. Brilliant. Convenience Mart or the gun shop? I'm just saying this may help later. Gun shop. There's probably some food in the houses anyway. Is that the gun shop? Maybe. Oh, hello, baseball bat. That's always good. I'll have that. No complaints about that. Army of machete-wielding YouTubers. That could be a YouTube Red series. God knows there's no other good YouTube Red series ideas right now. Yeah, trust is an issue in this game. Like, apparently characters can lie to you and stuff. So it may very well be that Jesse wasn't trustworthy and actually ate all the food in there. I believe that is something that can happen. Nothing in there. Having a group of four makes the game a lot easier, because it's very difficult to get surrounded. The AI is generally fairly efficient at meleeing anything that gets close. So that's good. Alright, well, I hope that wasn't the gun store, because there were no guns in there whatsoever. We're looking for food and medical supplies, and we're finding neither right now. Oh, there's a little bit of food at least. I'll take that. Get that. Let's put some food in there. You need like, what? We need 8 food a night? That's I assume it's 2 food per person, so. We'll have a little bit of that, shall we? Nothing in here. All there. Alright, so I think we've emptied that. I swear my weapons seem to break a lot faster than everyone else's do. Here, have this chair. Nope, get off. Where's the rest of my... Where's the rest of our dudes? Get back here. Did I trap them behind the chair? That's the problem. Okay. There we go. Come out swinging. It's getting to be nightfall. That's probably not good, is it? Oh, there's the gun store. Alright. In. Let's go, let's go. Please tell me there's something good in here. Well, bullets. This shotgun. Yes. Alright, we're in business. Pistol. Am I going to end up wasting all of the ammunition that I'm picking up from here? Probably. Disappointing to just see a shotgun in there. I was hoping for a little bit more than that. We did get some food, so that's not too bad. And I think there's some ammo in there as well. Is that it? Is that all that's in here? Well, that could have been better. I don't think that really helped us much. Well, that's everything that's available here, and I think we are out of most things now. Could be a problem. In the car! I like the fact that you need to bash the button over and over and over again to get the car to start. That's nice. Alright, so a bunch of ammunition. We did get 6 food, which is not too bad, but we're still lacking in medical supplies, and everyone's mostly dead. So... And if we don't find petrol soon, we're gonna have to abandon this. Okay, the group spots a group of bandits that have set up a checkpoint on the road. Someone from the team could be sent to distract the bandits. It would have to be someone calm and trustworthy. As in, not Jesse. Krendor is calm and trustworthy, surely. Krendor is sent to distract the bandits, and Jesse is killed. Fuck me. Krendor instantly turns on everyone and joins the bandits. Krendor leaves the team, and Jesse is killed. Fuck you. Well, that didn't go well at all, did it? Never trust a Krendor. It's probably our fault for sending someone with a mysterious past. I think we're all gonna die now on the death road to Canada. The group continues walking through the countryside. It's very uneventful, but at least there were no zombies. For the first time in a long time, they're able to drop some of their guard and walk in some sort of peace. Before they get horribly murdered. Everyone's morale decreases. Wind and rain move in during the night, catching the group by surprise. With no car to retreat to. Everyone is very upset. And I died! I ended up killing myself trying to treat my own wounds. The only person left is Peanut Butter Gamer. Who was robbed by weak bandits. The bandits are the kind that would normally not be a problem if Peanut Butter Gamer had a car and wasn't tired. They nervously demand all your extra gas and half your ammo and medical supplies. I mean, sure, I don't actually have any gas, so by all means... Take the ammunition, it's fine. Peanut Butter Gamer sees the dirt road stretch out into the distance. A lot of wrecked cars and zombies. We might find a car. I have a machete. An axe. And 1 HP. And we're trying to find the car. Alright. I don't foresee this going particularly well. Well, that's some petrol. At least he moves relatively quickly. Some more petrol over there. Skirting the outside seems to be relatively effective. I think this is one of those gauntlet runs. There's not. I don't think you have to get pet. You don't think you have to get keys. No, you don't. All right, cool. We're in the car. Get the hell out of here. Get out. Well, we got some gas and some pistol ammo and a tiny car. Peanut Butter Gamer finds a large campsite that is occupied by a few carloads of other survivors. Camping with strangers is risky, but there's nowhere else to go. I think we just camp with them. Oh. Peanut Butter Gamer takes a risk and goes to sleep in the crowded camp. In the morning, the other groups are gone and supplies are missing. Stole more of my ammunition, and Peanut Butter Gamer is very depressed. 9 days till Canada, though. We might survive. Bandits are guarding a retracted bridge over a river. They demand anyone passing pays a toll. They want all your extra gas and half your ammo. No! Let's jump it! I blew up the car. Peanut Butter Gamer is real mad about having to pay bridge tolls, even post-civilization. She runs right into the retracted bridge, sending the car flying past. The car barely makes it, but sinks like an anvil and smashes into the ground. Car destroyed. Well, at least we didn't have to pay. Peanut Butter Gamer runs into a particularly rough stretch of road. There's nothing life-threatening about it. It's just long and miserable. Morale decreases. She's very upset. Zombie hordes! Great! Well, we have to fight through a junkyard again with 1 HP, otherwise we ain't getting out. I thought this machete was better than that. Apparently not. Oh god, it's not even one of the straight run ones either. We need keys. Oh, for Christ's sake. I find our chances of survival slim. But there might be some decent loot in here. Maybe. If we're quick about it. Keys will be around here somewhere. This is a lot less easy without a horde of machete-wielding people to help. Also don't want to get boxed into a corner if I can avoid it. Keys are usually there, but apparently not this time. Shit. Shit. Shit! No! Well, this is looking fairly grim. Very grim. I think this is the quickest way out. No! Well, I mean, we got further than any other time. I'll take that. That's a fairly amusing game. I enjoy that. I think the addition of your friends helps a lot. There's a bunch of amusing events. Once you get a large group, it's a lot more fun because you can get through the salvaging and hunting segments a lot quicker. But I think that's pretty cool. That's a fair amount of fun. It's called Death Road to Canada. It's by Rocket Cat Games and Mad Garden. I think it's on Steam for 15 bucks. It's coming to iOS as well, I think. I don't think it's currently out on iOS, but it is coming. Yeah, that's not too shabby. I'll probably make an after-hour video about that one. It's a good amount of fun. I'm interested to see what happens with future runs. Hopefully there's good event variety in it. I enjoyed that. Never trust the Crendor, ladies and gentlemen. My name has been Totalbiscuit. Thank you very much for watching. I'm gonna go make an after-hour video of this. That'll be up on the channel tomorrow, most likely. Then, I mean, we could try playing No Man's Sky again. I'm gonna go try and tweak it again and see if any of the new fixes help. We'll see. There will be a show tomorrow, 6 p.m. Eastern. That will be Co-optional Lounge. Myself, Cry, Crendor, Jenna, and a couple of other special guests will be playing Snake Oil. So do tune in, 6 p.m. ET, at twitch.tv/totalbiscuit. See you next time.